Cycles.
Ladies and gentlemen, we present the starting lineup for your expert main events.
Here we go from Eatonville, Washington, on the Dodge Brothers Racing XR750, your season point leader. He could be your 2013 Grand National Champion, number 12, the Bullet, Brad Baker. Starting in the two spot for factory Harley-Davidson and Screamin' Eagle, ladies and gentlemen, the King of Cool, Kenny Coolbeth Jr. Here's the man that would be king. He's second in series points coming into this round, doing it for Crosley Radio and Howerton Motorsports, the Piper, national number 42, Bryan Smith. Sorry. Starting in the fourth spot from Washington on the Southeast Harley-Davidson, Flat Track Live Harley-Davidson, number 7, Slammin' Sammy Halbert. Starting in the fifth spot from Salinas, California, the Rod Lake Racing Specialty Fabricating Suzuki, number 14, Briar Bauman.
Barry, turn and face us.
Starting in the sixth spot from Clio, Michigan, on the Rogers Racing Harley, your defending champion, ladies and gentlemen, wearing his number one plate for the final time. Give it up for the jammer, Jared Mees. Up next, starting in the seventh spot from Morton, Illinois, the Weirbach Racing Harley-Davidson Kawasaki EX650. Ladies and gentlemen, national number 27, we call him Bugs, Robbie Pearson. The ringleader of the FBI, the Fast Boys from Illinois. Starting in the eighth spot from Westerlo, New York, on the Scotts Power Sports Kawasaki. Ladies and gentlemen, number 20, Matt Weidman. Going off in the ninth starting spot from Coatesville, Pennsylvania, the Lloyd Brothers Motorsports Ducati 749. Ladies and gentlemen, number 5, Jersey Jake Johnson. Starting in the 10th spot, he's a motorcycle road racer full-time and an exceptional flat tracker part-time from Philpott, Kentucky, doing it for TJ Burnett Farms. Number 95, we call him Jiggy Dog, JD Beach. Starting in the 11th starting spot, another one of the FBI from Peoria, Illinois, on the Greg Crow Racing Harley-Davidson. National number 61, we call him DC, Dustin Crow. Going off in the 12th starting spot, and he's third in series points with 3 wins in 2013, the TJ Burnett USC Kawasaki EX650 from Oxford, Pennsylvania. Number 44, Brandon Robinson. Starting in the 13th starting spot, he's one of yours from Salinas, California, the Zanotti Racing Schaefer Harley-Davidson XR, number 80, Stevie Bonzi. Starting in the 14th starting spot on the Bonneville Performance Factory Triumph from Acampo, California, ladies and gentlemen, number 91, we call him Fluffy, Mikey Martin. Starting in the 15th starting spot from Cedar, Minnesota, it's the DH Cycle Sales Harley, number 68, ladies and gentlemen, Josh Cook. Now we move to another one of the fast young riders, part of the FBI from Illinois. Number 23 on the Kiesel Racing, Eddie Atkins Harley. Number 23, Jeff Carver Jr.
Good luck, Dave.
Now we move to our 17th starting spot. What an interesting day this young man has had on the latest Motors Racing, Triumph Motorcycles Bonneville. Number 10, we call him JL10, Johnny Lewis. Starting in the 18th starting spot from Ventura, California, on the Weebler's Harley-Davidson, Roy's Taco House Machine from Ventura, California, ladies and gentlemen, number 98, Cale Kochman. And to a man who took a provisional to start this race here this evening, on the Kennedy Racing Harley-Davidson XR750, Hammerin' Hank Wiles. That's your field, ladies and gentlemen. How about a huge round of applause and send these warriors out to Pomona to do it right. Make some noise for them. Scotty?
Thanks a lot, Barry. Great job with the starting lineup. They'll give them one lap to check out the racetrack just like they did the pro singles. And it looks like they're trying to push start the 14 bike. That is Ronnie Brown out there, the head mechanic on the 14 bike, Briar Bauman. They will get one lap to check out the racetrack, and then we will turn them loose for 25 laps. We got 19 of the best flat trackers in the world. Also, a shout out to Blair, who's listening back home. Blair, we wish you were out here. Your dad, Darren, said hi. He came up here to see me just a moment ago. We're getting ready to do battle. 25 laps, we'll determine a champion. Right now, Baker is in the lead with 195 points. Bryan Smith, number 42, is in second with 183. And Robinson now sits 20 points back with 175 after the points they have earned from that dash for cash. Checking things out right now. Looks like Johnny Lewis is possibly going to start at the tail end of the field. Talking things over on the radio right now. Six riders on the first two rows. Johnny Lewis is choosing to start on row number four. He said he didn't like the middle of row number three. Johnny Lewis has that option. He will start on the middle of, on row number four. Henry Wiles had troubles with his transmission every time out on the 17 bike. They just said on the radio that Johnny Lewis, who was supposed to start in the middle of row number three, he is elected to start on row number four, which is legal according to the rules. You get your starting pick on whichever line you want. So Lewis did not like where he's sitting on the third row. He's going all the way back to the penalty line. Henry Wiles jumping on the backup motorcycle. He's way back there on row number four. 19 of them, 25 laps. We're gonna crown a champion of this race, the flat track finals, and of the 2013 AMA Pro Grand National Flat Track season. We'll have an awards presentation of this race, followed by the awards presentation of the 2013 season coming up in just a few moments here. Hope all you fans at home are enjoying the AMA Pro live streaming, a special addition to the 2013 season. And hopefully it's just as good as we think it's gonna be. There's a camera up in the crow's nest. There's one down there on the starting line and one up here in the announcer's booth. Danielle says it's good. It's time to go. 25 laps the distance. Red light is on. Four rows of motorcycles, ladies and gentlemen. Coolbeth from the outside trying to win the Pomona half mile back to back. Here we go. Flat track finals, Pomona, California. Light is green and they are off. Coolbeth pulls the front wheel, goes absolutely nowhere. Mees is going to lead him into one of two. One rider ducks down to the bottom of the racetrack. That'll be Bauman. Now they're three wide. Now they'll split the middle. Here comes the bullet. The points leader goes up the inside, takes over the lead. Here comes Smith from fifth. He's going for the lead. Smith goes from fifth up to second as Baker hangs on the throttle a little bit longer. It's the bullet, Brad Baker at the point. Smith in the two spot here. They come off of four. They're really sideways coming up at four. It's Baker, Smith, Mees, Bauman. Briar Bauman on the 14, SV1000. Suzuki back there in the four spot. Sorting things out up front. It's the bullet, Brad Baker. He leads him down the back straightaway by about 15 bike lengths. Watch. One rider down in turn number two. He's up high. I'm not sure who it is, possibly Henry Wiles. Rider is up. The ride bike is still out there in the middle of turn two. And there is the red light. So one rider going down in turn number two. There's the 17 bike. I thought it was Wiles. They're talking it over on the radio right now. Not sure who it is. Trying to listen in on the radio. So I believe we'll have a complete restart. I think we only had one lap in the books. If they ever revert back one lap, they will go back to a complete restart. They're talking 91 is what I'm hearing on the radio. The bike that went down, that is the factory Triumph rider, Mikey Martin, the rider down over there in turn number two. He's picked up that machine, climbed on board, and he's headed back over. And now, right now, he is the only bike that can actually work on his motorcycle. Complete restart is what I'm hearing on the radio right now with the 91 going all the way back to row number four. Everybody else is going back up to their starting spot. Baker's wanting some tear-offs. I can see he's got Kevin Atherton's hollering for some tear-offs. The Dodge Brothers number 12 bike. You're not allowed to work on the motorcycle. If you do, you go all the way to the tail end of the field. Some people are saying on the radio right now that some of the riders need some tear-offs. And here comes Mike Hacker, former national number 67 rider. He's coming out there to the number two bike. And they're staying on the radio right now. They're going to shut the engines down, give these riders an opportunity to add some more tear-offs to the lens of their helmets. So that's good news. I definitely want to be able to see to make it all the way to the 25-lap final. No, my partner Barry Boone's roaming around down there somewhere. Hopefully he can catch up to some of our riders.
Yeah, I'm down in the hot box, Scotty. The 91 machine, the factory Triumph of the Gately Bonneville Performance Team has arrived here. I think Mikey wanted to go straight to the starting line, but they told him they wanted to see him here. He said, I'm good. I believe the bike's good, but the team just wanted to take a minute and look it over. Here's Bill Gately, the team owner for the Bonneville Performance Team. They make just about every part on this motorcycle. You can buy it for your Bonneville as well. Mikey's explaining to the team how he lost the motorcycle. It looked like he just lost the rear end of the bike is what he indicated here to me. So the Triumph looks good, it sounds good, and he looks good, which is the best news. So Scotty, I believe he is going to rejoin this field here just any moment.
So they just told him on the radio right now they're gonna fire him back up. They did shut the engines down to make sure everybody could have a chance to put some more tear-offs on their helmet, and the track is clear. They said, let's fire them up. And there goes the 14, Ronnie Brown on that Suzuki SV1000, and it comes to life. So they're telling them right now on the fire them up. Some of the riders switching helmets. Some of the riders just adding tear-offs to their current helmet. Talking things over on the radio, waiting to see. But the 91 will go all the way back to the penalty line. He'll join Henry Wiles, who's using a provisional start card. Top 10 riders from last year in the Twins can use one provisional start card in a Twins race. We've seen that just a few times this year. They're telling them on the radio to fire them up, so the engines should come to life, and then we'll have the 25-lap main, and then the victory celebration will begin. Who will be our 2013 AMA Pro Grand National Champion? We'll find out in 25 laps. There goes Johnny Lewis. They're push starting that Triumph. Old school. Most of these bikes nowadays have a little socket-looking device sticking out the side of their cases. They stick a starter in the side of the side case and turn it over. And that's how they start most of these bikes. It looks like a couple of them using the old get out and push technique. Number two, Kenny Coolbeth outside row number one, looking to be a repeat winner here at Pomona. 42, Bryan Smith starting in the two spot. He had one heck of a drive down the back straightaway on that first restart, Barry.
Yeah, I was just going to point out to some of our newer fans, this is our starter. He's got the button in his hand. What happens, Scotty, as you well know, when everybody's good to go and he gets the indication the field belongs to him, he'll push that button and the computer begins running through a sequence. It can be really, really short or it can be excruciatingly long before that green light pops on and they're down and away.
Here we go, 25 lap. Grand National main event. Six riders on the front, six on row two. We're down to four riders on row three and three riders all the way back on row number four. 19 of the best flat trackers, here we go. Light is green and they're off. Bauman from the inside, Coolbeth trying to close the door on the outside. It's Bauman with the lead so far. Here comes the bullet up the inside. Baker. Mees just about steps off the motorcycle. He has to check out now. Here comes Baker. Now look at Smith up to second. He's looking for the lead. Smith goes to the lead for the first time in the main. Baker says, I don't think so. He leaves the throttle no longer, goes around the outside. It's Baker, high, wide, and handsome. Bryan Smith on the inside. Here they come. It'll be Brad Baker, your points leader, to lead him off of four. Baker, Smith, Mees, Bauman, Coolbeth right there on the number two bike. Mees back there in the sixth spot. As they went across the start-finish line, it is Baker, Bryan Smith, Jared Mees, Bauman, Coolbeth, Johnson, Halbert, Robinson, Weidman, J.D. Beach in the 10th spot. Down the back straightaway, it's the bullet. Brad Baker at the point. Riding the Harley-Davidson. We got a Kawasaki sitting in the 2 spot. Bryan Smith up the inside. He's looking for some more. Right now, it's the bullet in control. Baker, Smith, Mees, Bauman, Coolbeth, Sammy Halbert. Things changing in a hurry from third on back. Leaders breaking away. They're three wide for fourth place. They get things sorted out, get back in line down the back straightaway they go. Look at Smith now diving in deep into three. Trying not to let Baker get away. It's still Brad Baker out front, national number 12 on the number plate. Here comes Smith in the two spot, number 42. Third spot right now is Mees on the number one bike. Mees in third, Bauman fourth, Sammy Halbert in fifth, Coolbeth back there in sixth. Different lines by a lot of these different riders. Some of them going in low, drifting high. Some of the guys going in high, coming off the bottom of the racetrack. New leader going into turn number three. It is the Piper. Bryan Smith leads him into three. Baker goes around the outside, leaves the throttle on longer. Remember, he's got Kevin Atherton in his corner. He said, just twist that throttle. It's Baker. Smith now takes the draft pass going into one. Mees back here in the third spot. Bauman in four, Sammy Halbert in the fifth spot. Coolbeth in six, Jake Johnson in the seventh position. Behind Johnson's Robinson, Weidman, J.D. Beach. One rider down in turn number two. Rider down in turn number two. He's crawling back to the motorcycle. They're keeping him off. One rider also slows on the back straightaway. Track is clear. Weidman was the rider that went down. I'm not sure who slowed down on the back straightaway. Weidman went down. And now Baker just about steps off the motorcycle. Now he's going the right direction. Baker just about throws his championship away. He slides from second back to third. Baker just about goes down in turn number two. It must be treacherous over there. We've had three almost incidents, two of them for sure, in this main. There's Smith, Baker, Mees, Bauman. Weidman went down just a moment ago. Somebody stopped on the back straightaway. Not sure where that rider went. Something must be really treacherous in turn number two. Smith pulling away right now. Bonzi was the rider that pulled up early on the back straightaway. So Stevie Bonzi's 2013 season ends early. Here's your leader bringing him off of four. It is the Piper, Bryan Smith. Second is Baker. Third is Mees. Fourth is Bauman. Fifth is Sammy Halbert. Coolbeth back here in the sixth spot. Jake Johnson, seventh. Robinson shown in the eighth spot. Now Robinson slips back one position. J.D. Beach comes up and takes over the eighth spot. Robinson ninth, Johnny Lewis in 10th from the fourth row, ladies and gentlemen. Leader trying to check out. Bryan Smith coming into this one. He was 12 points behind Baker. That's a lot of positions on the racetrack. Smith trying to do everything he can. Baker in second, Mees back there in the third spot. Fourth is Mees, fifth is Bauman. Coolbeth and Halbert battling back there for fifth and sixth on the racetrack. Hearing on the radio that 98 Cal Kochman's got some fluid coming out of the motorcycles. They're going to check it out. Here's the leader, Smith. Baker's starting to track down the leader. Baker's catching Smith. This time by, we'll see what the time difference was. Smith goes now to the bottom of the racetrack, trying a new line. Smith's lead was 0.57 seconds, so just about a half a second. Baker's catching up to the leader. Mees back there in third spot, Bauman fourth, Sammy Halbert fifth, Coolbeth sixth, Jake Johnson in the seventh spot. Here comes the battle for the lead. It is Smith, Baker, Mees, Bauman now up to fourth, looking for his first podium. Coolbeth goes up the inside. Halbert had to check off the throttle. It's getting tight back in the pack. Side-by-side battle for third. Bauman looking for a podium finish. Baker looking for a Grand National Championship. Smith out front. Smith going really wide off of four. Here comes the bullet. Brad Baker is there. He's hungry. He doesn't want just the championship. He wants to win his second Grand National of his career. Look at Baker getting the drive off of two down the back straightaway. We got a new leader, Harley-Davidson out front. It is Baker now at the head of the class. Smith goes back up the inside. What a race we have here at the flat track finals. They are two by two, first and second, and third and fourth. Bauman looking for his first career podium. He's got his hands full with Mees. Baker and Smith, your championship points contenders battling right here for the lead. Baker gets the drive, he goes back to the bottom, he leads him off of turn number two. Baker and Smith side by side for the lead. They're also side by side for third and fourth. Bauman looking for his first podium. He is trying to get there. Here they come off of four. It's Baker and Smith trying to settle the championship. Smith goes back to the head of the class. Halfway flags are in the air. Halfway through this main event. The flat track finals 2013. Here comes Baker up the inside. Bauman's coming with them on the Suzuki. Bauman has caught up to the leaders also, and he's got Mees coming with them. Four riders doing battle. Looks like we're on a mile. Here comes Baker leading him off of four. Smith trying the high line once again. It is Baker, Smith, Mees, Bauman. Coolbeth settled into the fifth spot. Sammy Halbert in the sixth spot. Bryan Smith battling the inside of the track. Now here comes Baker back up the inside. What a classic race we have. Smith going up the inside in one and two, drifting high. Baker goes in high, comes off the bottom of the track. Leaders over here in three and four. Four riders trying to do battle for the win. Coolbeth sneaking up to him back there in the fifth spot. Here's Baker and Smith. Bauman in the third spot, Mees in fourth. Coolbeth catching up to our leaders. I hope my partner's aware that if Bauman gets on the podium, he wants me to be down there. This'll be fun. I don't know if I'm in as good a shape as Crazy Chris or not, but I'll have to find out. Look at the battle for the lead. Three riders trying to battle for the lead. Bauman looking for his first Grand National win. Here comes three of them off of four. Here comes the California rider. Briar Bauman wants a Grand National win. Now he slips wide, loses a little bit of ground. Baker gets the drive. He goes around the outside this time down the back straightaway. Rider down in turn number two is what I'm hearing. Red flag is flying. Rider down hard in turn number two is what I heard on the radio. Oh, into the hay bales. Past the air fence, it is rider number seven, Sammy Halbert. Halbert, the rider going down in turn number two. You can see he blasted through the hay bales over there. Halbert, the rider going down in turn number two through the hay bales. Woo! What a race we have. Bauman trying to look for his first career win, Barry.
Smith. Scotty, looks like he could do it here tonight.
Man.
He's really getting better. As this race progresses, Bauman continues to be faster and faster. My thoughts are right now with Halbert over there. That looked like a bad one.
He's up and okay. They have already said that on the radio. He's up
awesome.
And okay. He's looking for his motorcycle and trying to get that situated. They're actually pushing the motorcycle back as fast as they can. Halbert jumping in one of the Kawasaki mules to get a ride back here to the hot box. Nobody's allowed to work on their motorcycles during this red flag.
But apparently they're getting them down here, and all the teams are meeting them. They're changing out helmets. With new tear-offs, or they're changing out tear-offs. Here's Bauman on the Suzuki. He is looking so strong here. National number 14, trying to win his first Grand National and looking strong on that Suzuki. If you ride a V-Strom 1000 or a DL or a whatever the other one is, the sport model, an SV, that's what you're talking about right there, that little 1000cc Suzuki twin. They're going to work here on the machine of Bryan Smith, number 42.
Remember, they're not allowed to work on those motorcycles. If they do, they go all the way back to the penalty line, so we'll see.
Well, they were just getting the starter lined up. Okay. That's all he's doing. And they're all getting, they're definitely all going for tear-offs. Let's talk to Bauman. Good race you got going on here, young man.
Holy cow, man. I was ready to start working my way to the back, but it didn't start happening yet, so I just wanted to stay with these guys and just learn the pace. It's cool to run with them and know that you're at the front.
Yeah, buddy, you're looking strong here. Good luck at the finish of this one. My partner, Scotty, said he'll try to get down here for that interview. They'll give you some incentive.
Man, I want to see him bad.
Scotty, he said, I want to see that guy worse than anything in the world. That means he's earned a podium here.
Well, that's right. He's looking for it, and we made a deal a long time ago when Briar came on the scene. If he ever got on a Grand National podium, I would be the one to interview him. So
that's cool.
Yeah, so he's trying to do it. I know he wants to do it for other reasons, but that would be pretty awesome if he could do it here in California. Coolbeth, though, keep your eyes on the number two bike. This will let him regroup a little bit. He was tracking down the top four riders as they were all dicing it out.
He was actually closing and catching those top four. We were about to have a five-rider battle at the head of the class, and you said something near the end, just before the red came out with Halbert crashing over there, that I think is significant. All night long, this racetrack has reminded me of a mile flat track show, Scotty. Yeah. And it really looks and has the feel of a mile.
Especially with those four riders breaking away like they were and doing some classic high-low, different lines going into the corners, different lines coming off the corners. That's not typically like a mile, but the way the four pack, pack of four riders broke away, that reminds me of a mile race. So it's been super good from up here. I don't know how about
many,
down there.
How many laps do we have left? I've lost count here at the end.
I'm not telling you.
Okay, good. Cool.
I'm just kidding. 10 laps is what I'm hearing.
Oh,
but
man.
They might revert back one lap. I'll have to wait and hear what the official word is. So it's either 10 or 11.
That definitely adds to the drama that I'm seeing down here, because with 10 or 11 laps remaining, that's a good old Saturday night shootout here for the championship. They've raced all year to get to this point. I'm liking that our two contenders, really, we do have three, Brandon Robinson in this thing too, but I'm liking that the 42 of Bryan Smith is up there and battling so hard with number 12, Brad Baker, those two going back and forth, lap after lap. That's how championships should be decided.
Absolutely. It'll come all the way down to the finish line with Baker right now. He's looking for his second career Grand National victory. He has been Mr. Consistency this year with top fives at every round except for Virginia, where he did have that one mechanical issue. So Baker right now is trying to finish again on the podium, and he wants his second career Grand National victory. Baker's right now shown as the leader, Smith in second, Bauman back there in the third spot, and we'll have the staggered restart. We haven't even talked about it because this is the first one we've had all night. So for you news fans that have never been to a flat track race, we used to go nose to tail or rear tire to front tire and so forth all the way back. Now it's a staggered start, and if that rider in front of you doesn't get going, you can go right around them.
Yeah, it makes it for a little safer start, too. Another interesting observation I'm seeing down here is we've got the Harley-Davidson XR750, the Dodge Brothers Harley of National Number 12, Brad Baker, running in the one spot. In the two spot is the Kawasaki EX650, the Crosley Radio Howerton Motorsports Kawasaki in the two spot. And then third is the Suzuki 1000 for Bauman, National Number 14. So good parity going on here in this one up front.
Great points you brought out. It's interesting to see the 1000cc Suzuki running up there with him as he's right there currently in the third spot. Mees, don't count him out yet either. It's giving him a chance to regroup, talk to one of the best tuners in the business. Kenny Coolbeth now turning the wrenches on the number one bike. They're talking things over down there. Of course, you can't do any work to the bike, but they're talking things over, see what kind of strategy they can come up with. Also, to fill you in on what happened a little bit earlier, the rider that went down early on in the main in turn number two was the 20 of Matt Weidman. Somehow kept the motorcycle running. He is back out there and still capable of finishing this one. He scored right now. It looks like one lap down according to what I have up here. Don't know if that's official or not. At about the same time, the 80 of Stevie Bonzi, he came up short and shut off the Zanotti Racing XR750 early. So that's what happened to Bonzi. He'll be credited with the 19th finishing position.
The riders are getting new tear-offs and getting these helmets ready to go. Here comes Kenny Coolbeth. The factory Harley-Davidson pilot, National Number 2, Mike Hacker holding up the machine. Everybody remembers the Hackman from his racing days. Kenny, I know you don't want to chat long, but you were catching those top four, trying to make a race out of it here. This red flag's a little bit of a benefit for you, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It just took us so long to get in a rhythm, and those guys kind of got away. So this is good. See what happens.
Good luck to you. I'm going to try to get a word here with the jammer if he'll talk to me. I know these guys are focused right. Jared, you got a great show going on here, buddy. You could be the whole spoiler thing in this championship. I know you're trying to win one. That's all.
Yeah, I always came here with a championship on my plate and kind of rode really conservative, but no championship on the plate right now, and I just want to pull off the year with a win and kind of needed this. You know, I kind of was starting to fall off the pace a little bit, and it's a whole different ball game now.
You're definitely in the thick of the hunt here right now. That is the defending champ, National Number 1. Jared Mees getting set to go back. Here I'm looking back at number 95, J.D. Beach, who normally can be found on the weekends in the Geico Motorcycle AMA Pro Road Racing Series on his Road Race Factory Red Bull Yamaha R6. But here today, he is mounted on the TJ Burdett Farms Kawasaki EX. Behind him is the Badfast Lloyd Brothers E&I Ramspur Winery Ducati, number 5, with Jersey Jake Johnson twisting the grip on that. So all the stars are in this one, Scotty. It's going to be a fun 10 or 11 laps. Have a great call, partner. We'll see you at the end.
Sounds good. It's getting close. They've told him to fire up, but they're also checking on the number 80 bike, making sure that track is clear. You can see Bonzi's walking his Harley down the backside. So they have a long walk back. Looks like they're going to send out the Kimco scooter to go pick him up and bring him back around, make sure that track is clear. And they will get him off the racetrack, and they're going to turn him loose. And Corey Texter, defy all odds, he's listening at home, the Next Moto Champion Associate Editor.
Yeah, C-Tex, he's also the host of the Tuesday night NextMotoChampion.com flat track show that you and I are part of, and he's on just about every show. You and I get to have fun every now and then.
Listen to what he's saying. He's saying, keep your eyes on the number 2 bike. He said, it's Kenny Coolbeth's race now.
I got to believe that he's going to be a factor in this one, Scotty. I'm not quite that confident to pick any one rider in this top 5, 6, 7 bikes.
Yeah, I was going to say, don't count out J.D. Beach. He's been steadily picking his way through the lineup. He'll be on the inside, have a great shot at the inside line. J.D. Beach on his 22nd birthday, starting back in about the 5th or 6th spot. So it's Baker, Smith, Bauman, Mees, Coolbeth, 95 of Beach, 5 Johnson, 27 Pearson having a great run, 44 is Robinson, Johnny Lewis on the 10, Cale Cookman on the 98, Mikey Martin on the 91, behind him 61 D-Rod Dustin Crow, 23 Jeff Carver, 20 Matt Weidman, and at the tail end of the field is the 68 of Josh Cook.
I want to give a shout out to Don, our sound man, who's been working so hard since early morning this morning, and the farm, who came up with about $36,000 worth of equipment for us to use here this evening at, I think, no charge. So thank you, Don. Thanks for all that you've done for us here, and thanks to the farm.
Don't forget, after this one, we'll have the victory celebration for this race, and then we'll have a short break, and we'll come back with the victory celebrations for the entire 2013 season. You folks are more than welcome to stick around and listen and watch. It's all on the victory podium. We'll give the overall season awards. As they're pushing back the number 80, that's Stevie Bonzi's bike getting a free ride back to the pit area.
Scotty, don't you love it? Here's Briar Bauman, national number 14, one of the young, up-and-coming experts, standing there alongside a guy that's become quite the series veteran and a standout star himself, Jared Mees. Got to wonder what those two are talking about. I can kind of see they're talking about bikes handling, so they're talking about this racetrack. There's Bonzi's machine. He came riding back with Ray Rizzo on the mule. So Stevie Bonzi's bike has made it back here.
All right, just moments away from firing them up. I believe there's going to be 10 or 11 laps. I never heard that officially. I'm showing 15 on my screen, but I believe they revert back one lap. They have to push start the 14 bike. That is Bauman. Engines come to life. So we have a restart. I believe it's going to be 11 laps, so that's totally unofficial. Kind of like a heat race now, but they're all staggered. I believe 18 of them possibly going to make the restart.
I don't think Stevie Bonzi is going to make the call. I really don't.
He definitely is not going to make it. He's shown 10 laps down. I don't see the 17 bike out there of Wiles either, so I don't know what happened to him. And they're staged up. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen, the restart. Watch the light. If anybody jumps, they will be docked several positions. They just told all the riders that just a moment ago. Here we go. Light is green. A great restart. Here we go. Baker will lead him into one. Smith right there in second. I don't see Henry Wiles out there. It looks like he did not make the restart. Sammy Halbert was the rider that went down in turn number 2. I don't see him out there as well. Look at this battle out front. 4 riders trying to do battle. Then there's about 8 riders in a big pack for 5th on back. Hang on, 1 rider going down. No, he's up. He almost went down. I don't know who it was. They saved it. Here they all come off of 4. It's Baker, Bauman, Smith, Mees. As they dive in deep. Carver now at the tail end of the field. He's having some troubles out here in this main. Off of turn number two, down the back straightaway. It is Baker, Bauman. Here comes Smith on the Kawasaki. He moves up there into the two spot. It's the bullet, Brad Baker, trying to win his championship. Smith is right there trying not to let it happen just as easy as he can. They all come back this direction. It is Baker, Bauman, Smith, Mees, 95 J.D. Beach, Coolbeth right there in the sixth spot as Beach is coming towards the front. J.D. Beach on the 95, T.J. Burnett Farms Kawasaki coming towards the front on his birthday. Smith drips wide. He loses a lot of time to Bauman. It's the bullet, Brad Baker, looking for a championship. He'll be the third youngest rider and fourth youngest to do it. Springsteen won two championships before he was Baker's age. Baker out front, Bauman, Bryan Smith, Jared Mees back there in the fourth spot, J.D. Beach in fifth, Kenny Coolbeth in the sixth spot as they go across the line. Johnson in seventh, Robbie Pearson, Brandon Robinson, Johnny Lewis, Cale Cookman, Mikey Martin, Dustin Crow, Jeffrey Carver, Matt Weidman, 15 of them on the racetrack. It is Baker, Bauman, and Smith right there. Smith up the inside on the Kawasaki. Here comes Bauman getting the drive, trying to take over the inside, coming down the long front straightaway. Long straightaways, tight corners. It's the bullet, Brad Baker looking for a championship. Looking for a Grand National victory number two of his career. Bauman squares off the turn number two and drives down the back straightaway. Five lap board coming out next time by 5.5 miles to go. Here comes your leader off of four. Baker's starting to get some company now. Bauman and Smith neck and neck down the back straightaway. Looks like Smith has a little bit more motor at the end of the straightaway. It is Baker, Smith, Bauman, Mees, J.D. Beach still in the fifth spot. Coolbeth in sixth, Jake Johnson seventh, Robbie Pearson eighth, Brandon Robinson ninth, Johnny Lewis rounds out your top 10. Baker goes back to the high side, Smith comes to the bottom. That line is holding up for the bullet. He drops to the bottom of the racetrack coming off of four. Smith is all the way sideways, looks like one of the speedway bikes out there. There's Baker, four more laps. Smith in second, Bauman third, Mees wants to get on that podium. J.D. Beach in the fifth spot, sixth is Coolbeth. Seventh is Johnson. Eighth, Robbie Pearson, ninth, Brandon Robinson, 10th is Johnny Lewis. The bullet, Brad Baker trying to win his first career championship in his third year as an expert. Matt Weidman comes up short on the back straightaway, puts his hand in the air, pulls out of harm's way. It's Baker, Smith, Bauman in the third spot. Smith putting on a charge, trying to come up and take the win. Laps are winding down here at the flat track finals. There goes the 91. I heard a big pop as he went into turn number one. Mikey Martin's day is done. Another bike pulls off. That's Weidman pulling off the racetrack on the 20. Look at the battle for the lead. Here comes Smith. Smith's not done yet. Smith takes the lead because it crossed the start finish line. Baker shuts the door. Two laps to go. They're going to decide this one all the way down to the checkered flag. Baker has a 12-point lead coming into this race. So if they finish just like this, it's going to be Baker your champion. Here comes Smith. He waited till the final laps to put on the move. Baker twists the throttle around the outside. Here they come. Baker and Smith. Baker, Smith, Bauman, 1, 2, and 3. White flag is in the air. One more half mile to go. Smith goes back to the bottom of the racetrack. Baker, now Smith goes up to the high side. Baker has about 10 bike lengths off of turn number two down the back straightaway. Bauman right there in the third spot. That means I'm going to have to come to the victory podium. Man, promises, promises. Here comes your champion of the 2013 season off of turn number four. He did it in style, ladies and gentlemen. Brad Baker's going to take the Grand National Championship and the victory. Baker, your winner. Smith in second, Bauman in the third spot. That means I got to go trackside in just a moment. I'm reading the final finishing order, then I'm headed down there. So here we go, ladies and gentlemen. The main event and championship comes up. Number 12 is your 2013 AMA Pro Grand National Champion and winner of tonight's race, Bryan Smith in second, Briar Bauman third, Jared Mees fourth, J.D. Beach fifth, Kenny Coolbeth sixth, Jake Johnson seventh, eighth goes to Robbie Pearson, ninth Brandon Robinson, 10th to the number 10 Johnny Lewis, 11th Cale Kochman on the 11. 11th goes to Kochman, 12th is Carver, and 13th Dustin Crow. Everybody else off the track, Mikey Martin, Matt Weidman, Sammy Halbert, Henry Wiles, Josh Cook, and Stevie Bonzi. I'm coming to see you, Barry.
Yeah, you got to come down here. This gets too excited. He just slid past us at about 100 an hour. Here comes number 42, Bryan Smith. There's Shayna. Hi. He's making his way down. All the players are beginning to assemble here. Here's national number 12, ladies and gentlemen, Brad the Bullet Baker, your 2013 AMA Pro Grand National Champion in the Experts. How cool is that? He's getting congratulations from the team. They're all there. There's old Cupcake, Kevin Atherton, celebrating with him. The Dodge brothers have done it. They brought their man to the front, and he has settled it all here. Great ride by Bryan Smith today, no doubt. Up front, doing all that he could do, wrestling that bear all the way to the checkered flag. Great ride for national number 42. We'll talk to him in just a moment. My partner Scotty's on his way down. We'll have our victory podium celebration. We'll follow that with our awards ceremony coming up here in just a bit. Bryan Smith, too, getting congratulations all around here. And the entire Howerton Motorsports team, they have nothing to hang their head about. They have been gallant competitors all season long, and they've turned in a good one here tonight at Pomona for the amazing final race here. It's just phenomenal what we have seen and what we've all witnessed here this evening. History in the making, third youngest rider to win a championship, and he's done it here at the Law Tigers Flat Track Finals at Pomona. We've got some folks lining up down here. They're all set. Dad just asked his children, hey, man, are you guys ready to get some champagne on you? They're all going, yeah. So, hey, they're good to go here as we await the arrival of the race winner and our 2013 national champion. He'll be here in a moment, and we will be set to go with our victory podium. Got to say one more time before we end this wonderful evening, we have to say congratulations to Brad Baker, national number 12. We want to thank our friends at Law Tigers. We want to also thank the folks at Pomona Harley-Davidson, Pomona Valley Harley-Davidson, and Glendale Harley-Davidson for all that they've done here. But mostly our hats off to these fans out here enjoying a cool night in Pomona. Unseasonably cool out here in XR750. And there he is, ladies and gentlemen, your 2013 national champion, Brad Baker. Scotty's going to begin our celebration here with our third place finisher's first podium interview. We've got Bryan Smith on his way here to the podium. There he is. There's the Piper.
And also in just a few moments, we'll have the year-end awards also. So we'll get our victory podium up here as soon as the Bullet makes his way up here. And got this happy youngster beside me for third spot. We'll get this. This guy, he said he didn't even know where the podium was.
He found it.
I'm just kidding. We'll start with third spot. I guess you want to go and start or you want to wait?
Let's do it.
Bama, come up here. We made a promise, you and I did a long time ago, that when you got on your first Grand National career podium, that I would be the one to interview you. So here you are, and congratulations for getting third place here tonight.
Thanks, Scotty. It feels good to see you because it happened. So that face has never looked so good.
And your girlfriend had to give you the helmet because you had to bring that up here and show off that you're sponsored by Rye. And what a great night, and you almost won that thing. Congratulations on third place. I'm proud of you, and what a great, great day for you.
Yeah, it was an awesome day. We started out good, and, you know, usually when we start out good, we're not sure which way we're going to go. It's kind of up in the air, and, you know, I felt it in my heat race, felt it in the dash, and I'm like, man, I know if I get a start with those guys, I can work with them. And there for a second before the red flag, I'm like, dude, I led this for like half a second, and Brad had, he was out on a mission, man. He got out there. I watched him almost high side his brains out once. It scared me half to death, and he never missed a beat. So congratulations to him and Brian. And I think the only reason I was really right up in there was because they were battling out so hard, but I was ready to cap on it if anything happened. So thanks to all my sponsors.
Good job. Congratulations. Enjoy your first podium. We're going to go over to my partner, Barry Boone. I told you I'd be here.
Well, we are. And just before we go with our second place interview, for those of you maybe a little bit new to flat track, it's an age-old tradition for the man who's giving up the number one plate to bring it up and hand it to the man who's just earned it. Hats off to Jared Mees. You were a great champion for us in 2013, and he has passed the torch as he has handed that number one plate to Brad Baker. Now let's turn our attention to the man that's had an incredible season, doing it for Crosley Radio and Howerton Motorsports, riding his heart out all year long. Maybe came up a little short, but he's definitely in the house. Can't wait for 2014. Ladies and gentlemen, national number 42, second today, Bryan Smith. How you feel, partner?
Good. It was a dogfight out there. It was a heck of a race with Brad. I'm just happy we fought each other tooth and nail, and it was a clean race. And it's not very often you can do that these days, and so I appreciate that. It was a fun day. I would much rather won, but it was fun.
It was really fun. You gave us all a real show up front. You two just slugging it out all race long. Then we had the red at the end, which created a little more drama. Still, you came out of the box ready to do battle.
Yeah, I was ready all day. You know, Brad was a click faster all day, and I was on the edge trying to keep up, and we did get in front of him there for a minute, and that restart kind of got me out of a rhythm, but we were right there at the end. I just messed up on the last lap and let him get a little too much room on me, but congratulations to him and his whole team. It's cool to see it.
I don't know how you say thank you to a team like you've got, but I know you want to.
Yeah, the Howard Motorsports crew, everybody, Crosley Radio, it's just unbelievable how much fun we've had this year and how good we've did. Come up a little bit short in the championship, but we'll be back next year. I'll be back next year strong as ever.
That's something we all can look forward to, ladies and gentlemen. Second place today, second place in the 2013 championship. Give it up for the Piper, Bryan Smith, national number 42. And now it's an honor to discuss what just happened on this racetrack. First, we're going to talk about our race. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner today in the Law Tigers Flat Track Finals at Pomona, national number 12, the Bullet, Brad Baker. Bullet, let's talk about your race. You and Bryan Smith up there just slugging it out every lap.
Yeah, I mean, that was probably the best race of the whole entire series right there. There probably wasn't that many lead changes on the Springfield Mile sometimes, you know. Heck, we were just there for, like, the beginning of the race before the red flag. I mean, I would pass him coming out. He'd pass me going in. We were just flip-flopping, having fun. I almost got off real bad in between one and two one time. I mean, Briar said my legs were straight up in the air at one time, and I saved that one. And after that one, I was like, man, I better calm down a little bit and find out a different line. And I kind of figured that line out when I ran Brian back down, and I figured, hey, if I get this whole shot, I can just run that line and stay smooth. And, that's exactly what I did. And I could still feel him there coming to the inside, but every time I'd still get out of the corner a little bit better. And the last three laps, my brake lever fell off. And usually you don't need brakes on a track like this, but I found out that you actually do need them a little bit after that happened. So I was having to let off a little bit early. But, you know, hats off to Brian. He's been an awesome competitor all year long. You know, we've had some amazing battles, and you know, with this win, you know, the end off the year, not only just get the championship, but to end it off with a win is awesome. Can't thank that big dude right there enough, Tony Dodge. He's been behind me this whole year. You know, we've almost been racing on shoestrings compared to some people, you know, but it doesn't matter when you have somebody like Dave Atherton building them, Tony funding them, and me and Kevin driving around the country in a little van, making the whole deal happen. It's been an awesome 2013 season. It's amazing. I can't believe it.
Well, the thing that you've worked for all year long, the moment has arrived for you to receive it. And for that, ladies and gentlemen, we present from the American Motorcyclist Association, Mr. Joe Bromley. Thank you for being here, Joe. Ladies and gentlemen, this is for your 2013 national champion.
Thanks, Barry. Well, Brad, a little bit earlier this year back at Peoria, I had the opportunity to present you the Expert Singles Championship. And I know, you know, that was a well-deserved championship, but you had your eyes set for the Grand National Championship. You were consistent all year, always up on the box, always on the top five. It's a great pleasure on behalf of the American Motorcycles Association to present you your 2013 AMA Grand National number one plate.
Brad?
It's just a true honor, you know. This year has had some ups and downs, you know. In Daytona, I had some points taken away from me, and it wasn't nobody's fault. But, you know, it took me a couple days to bounce back from that. And just, you know, I just figured, hey, it's a drive to put my head down even further, you know. And to come here and sew up this just championship, you know, I sealed up the singles champion, I'm like, man, that was a tough feat right there. But to come here, it feels amazing, and I just can't thank AMA Pro Racing, Saddleman, Harley-Davidson, everybody behind this this whole series, all the promoters all year long for making this deal happen. You know, I would do this race, this sport, if I was making nothing, you know, and just to be able to do something I truly love, make my living at it, and I take pride in this just as much as anybody else. You know, it's amazing. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, though spoken like a true champion that he is, your 2013 AMA Pro Grand National Expert Champion is standing before you. National number 12, Brad the Bullet Baker. That is, that's going to pretty much put the finishing touches on our post-race show featuring Victory Podium. They'll celebrate here and get their photographs made. All of you fans who've joined us, thank you. But I want you to know the champagne will be flying shortly. And if you don't want a champagne shower, you might slip to the back of this line. Otherwise, feel free to stay. Mom, congratulations. Dad, congratulations. Couldn't be happier of you. Great job with that young man right there. I know you're really proud of him. We all are. Well, I don't know where my partner is. I'm going to sign off for him. We'll be back here in a matter of moments as soon as we get this all turned around, and we'll have our awards ceremonies here on the stage in just a few minutes. For Scotty Dubler and crazy Chris Ackerman, all three voices that were here, and for all of us at AMA Pro, everyone with TAG, everyone from Law Tigers, and the folks with Pomona Valley Harley and Glendale Harley-Davidson, we say thank you. Thank you to all of you fans here at the racetrack, and a special thank you to everyone watching, looking, and listening at home at amaprolive.com. We're glad to have you with us as well. I'm out of here. Good night.